Hi guys, welcome to the 9th and 10th episode recap of the K-drama agency. With a plot spoiler alert, let's get to it. Ayeon and her team prepare for the ad campaign competition. After checking everything up, Ayeon sends her team home to get ready to go to Woo-won. Hannah calls in both Ayeon and Chang-su to review their presentations. But to everyone's surprise, Ayeon shows up at her office empty-handed. She refuses to do a review in front of Hannah and Chang-su, claiming that they are done with the editing. Remembering Han-soo's remarks that he will be there to watch the presentations, Ayeon invites Hannah to Woo-won if she wants to see Ayeon's presentation. Eun-jung, on the other hand, waits outside her apartment giving time for her son to go to kindergarten. But she finds her son at home because he has caught himself a cold. So Eun-jung quickly rushes away from him when he asks her about handing over her work to someone else. Just like Ayeon wanted, Hannah shows up at Woo-won to watch the presentations. As she waits, she gets furious on seeing Han-soo rushing to the presentation room. So she realizes the reason Ayeon wanted her to be at the presentation is because of Han-soo. Ayeon gets to present last, while Chang-soo gets to present the one before last. Each of the presenting groups is called in individually to present to Woo-won group. Ayeon gets a call from Jung-hun to inform her that Woo-won lawyers are there in the presentation room. Hannah walks in as Chang-soo starts his presentation, saying that she is there to observe. When Soo-jung and Han-soo unwelcome her, Hannah points out that it's inappropriate for Han-soo, who is the vice president of the VC group, to sit in a presentation room in which VC planning is competing, which others might interpret as Han-soo influenced the judging, if VC planning does win the competition. By the time Ayeon presents, Woo-won group is annoyed by the presentations they've watched so far. So Ayeon as well presents a lengthy boring presentation which irritated Soo-jung. She points out that they are inattentive, and then presents her real presentation, which is Chairman Won-woo's bail project, which catches everyone's attention. Ayeon shows them the advertisement which they've created by interviewing Seok-jae. Apparently he's a man who has been wrongly accused of murder, and has been imprisoned for 23 years because of an arrest investigation. The advertisement manages to make the public opinion against the arrest investigation, and so Woo-won gets his bail. Hannah then meets with Moon-ho, demanding him to fire Chang-soo because he lost the presentation. Moon-ho explains to her that if Hannah abuses her power like she's trying right now, only the incompetent ones will remain in the company. So he suggests him to transfer Chang-soo instead of firing him, just like Ayeon transferred all the employees who got promoted through company politics. Eun-jung goes home determined to tell her family about her promotion, and that she didn't actually quit her job. To her shock, her husband and mother-in-law don't get surprised upon hearing the news. Apparently they have already figured out that Eun-jung didn't resign, judging by the way she acted. So Ah-ji is the only one who has been fooled by her acting, and doesn't take it well. So Eun-jung strongly tells him that she has no intentions to resign from the job. The next morning at the breakfast, Geun-cheol gets interested to know Ayeon, and decides to meet with her personally. When Han-soo informs him that Woo-won-too wanted to meet Ayeon, Geun-cheol suggests inviting Ayeon over for dinner, since Woo-won-too will be joining them. As Hannah leaves for work with Young-woo, both Han-soo and Tae-wan notice that Hannah is unusually close to Young-woo. At the office, Young-woo relays Geun-cheol's and Woo-won's intentions to meet with her, so she has been invited to join them for dinner. Ayeon is surprised to hear it, so Young-woo tells her what she should do when she meets Geun-cheol when Ayeon asks for his advice. Even though it's uncomfortable for her, Ayeon manages to make it through the dinner. On Geun-cheol's orders, Young-woo ends up driving Ayeon back home. When she wonders why he's helping her, Young-woo clarifies that they have a give-and-take relationship, so he's now giving what she needs, for him to later take something back. Ayeon asks Young-woo to drop her off at Jung-seok's restaurant. So before Young-woo leaves, he does take a photo of the address of the restaurant. Ayeon goes home and happily goes to bed after taking her pills. To her shock, she wakes up on a bench wearing pajamas outside her apartment building. She is shocked to see her there, and has no memory of how she got to the bench. So she goes to the CCTV footage and sees her walking out in the middle of the night and sleeping on the bench. Ayeon realizes that she's having side effects of the overusage of the drug Soo-jin warned her of. Chang-su, on the other hand, gets informed by Tae-wan about the transfer request Hannah has made to assign him to the Busan office. Chang-su is shocked to see it, and argues that he should try to side with Han-soo, now that Hannah clearly wants to work with Ayeon. Tae-wan informs about Han-soo noticing Hannah's and Young-woo's close relationship, and asks Chang-su to look into them, whether they are actually in a relationship. If they are, Hannah's career would be short-lived since Geun-cheol would never approve of the relationship. So Chang-su gets Woo-cheol to spy on Han and Young-woo. Ayeon then goes to see Soo-jin and informs her about her condition. Soo-jin gets worried about her condition, explaining that Ayeon could even die at this rate. Refusing to listen to Soo-jin, Ayeon goes for a walk in the park. Jae-hoon also joins her when he learns where she is and helps her calm herself and enjoy the surrounding. While joking around with Young-woo, Hannah comments that they should start dating or even get married. To Hannah's surprise, Young-woo leans forward and asks her what she knows about him. Hannah admits that she feels comfortable around Young-woo, so Young-woo takes her straight to the city office, so as to register their marriage. Young-woo admits to her that he has feeling for her, but the only problem is that she is a daughter of a rich conglomerate owner. So Young-woo reasons that it's not realistic for them to be a couple. Hannah does remember that Joon-cheol is against showing affection to their employees. Woo-cheol, who has been tailing them, snaps photos of Hannah and Young-woo together. So the photos then reach Chang-su. Han-soo, noticing Hannah sharing a mint chocolate ice cream post on her social media, does the same with the chocolate ice cream. But Han-soo's post gains a lot of criticism, which ultimately makes Yong-ho angry at him for wasting company money to cover up his mistakes. Tae-wan gets informed by Chang-soo about the photos he managed to get of Hannah and Young-woo, and demands to set up a meeting with Han-soo, so that he can get close to him. So Tae-wan goes to Han-soo and informs him about Chang-soo, and that he can even help him with managing his social media, so that he wouldn't get into trouble. After work, Hannah refuses to go home with Young-woo. At the elevator, she meets Ah-in and invites her to have a drink with her. But Ah-in declines, saying she has other plans. They run into Chang-soo, who assumes that Hannah and Ah-in are going out together, so he happily goes to meet with Han-soo, which he set up with the help of Tae-wan. But to Chang-soo's horror, he finds Ah-in already with Han-soo when he gets to the meeting. Han-soo right away asks for the information Chang-soo wanted to share with him. So reluctantly, Chang-soo shows him the photos of Hannah and Young-woo in front of Ah-in. Han-soo agrees to cancel Chung-soo's transfer to Busan, and tries to convince Ah-in to side with him. Eun-ja goes to an employment agency looking for work in the company Ah-in works in. Hannah ends up drinking with Moon-ho. Moon-ho helps her realize that she is feeling ashamed for not being able to do anything about her feelings, and advises her that she'll either have to change the way she feels, or change the world around her. To her surprise, Young-woo shows up as usual and waits for her at a different table. So she leaves and decides to go home quickly, so that Young-woo can get off from work. The next morning, Joon-cheol sees Han-soo giving Young-woo a warning. Joon-cheol happily decides to encourage the fight between the two siblings, and calls for Ah-in. He straightaway asks her which sibling she'd like to work with, and then the episode ends. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you again next time.